How does your car cost you a lifetime of earnings lost and savings lost, really? Hello everyone, this is Ricey and welcome to my channel, The Quest for Wealth. Many people do dream about owning and buying the fastest, the biggest, the nicest, the most sleek kind of car available in the market. And the first question that they ask is, where can I take a loan from? Which bank would provide me the highest amount of loan? And will take them, I don't know, 5 years, 10 years to pay for a car that doesn't give you anything. A car loses value. It doesn't give you anything. It doesn't provide you any earnings, cash flow. It takes money away from you month in, month out. Every single time you put gas on it. The very first car that I purchased was a brand new car. It was back in 2008. Oh my god, I'm old. it was a sedan. It was a very cute one. It was a Peugeot sedan car, and I just had my driver's license during the time, and I was very excited to have a car of my own. And of course, being excited, first time driver, the first question was, where can I get a loan from? And I want to buy this car. And so I did. I took a loan. It was payable for 5 years. So after 3 years of purchasing that car, I was promoted to be a junior sales and marketing manager for the company, and the company provided me a car. So I had to let go of that Peugeot one. And so I went to my bank and I told them that I am canceling or terminating my loan. And what the situation was, or what the scenario is, that, or with car loans specifically, it doesn't matter if you pay the car loan 2 years ahead of time, 3 years ahead of time, or 1 year ahead of time, you still have to pay the entire 5 years of the interest cost plus the actual loan. And as soon as I learned that very moment, it was very disproportionately disturbing to me, because I had to pay for the entire 5 years of the interest. From that moment on, I decided I will never, ever take a loan for a car, and I will never, ever buy a brand new car. Because when I sold that car, I lost about 70% of the value of the car. And you know, being a European, a French car, it's not necessarily a value for resale. It's not a good value for resale. Even up to this date, European cars are not good value for resale. And until this very moment, the cars that I bought were all paid in cash, and I never bought a brand new car. And that is one learning I would like to provide to you, or to share with you. Because what is the essence of buying a brand new car? Why do you have to take on the lost value of a car when you buy brand new? You can just allow another person to take the loss of the value of that car and let him buy that car brand new, and wait 2 years, 3 years until such car is on market, on sale, and buy it. Of course, somebody else had taken the lost value of the car, and you just pay for the second-hand or used car. There's nothing wrong with buying a used car, really. From that moment, I never believed in the idea of buying a brand new car. It's an absolute waste. And another thing is that taking a loan for a car, taking a loan for a brand new car, is another waste of money, really. Why would you spend your money paying for that car for 5 years, where you can take that money and invest it in something else, and that money could propel you to achieve your financial goals faster, quicker, and with less stress? Why don't you? I believe, and this has already been my tactic. Whenever I buy a car, I always have a limit. I always work on a budget, and I have never taken a loan for a car after that first experience with that Peugeot back in 2008. Because as soon as I terminated that loan, I calculated the amount of money that I lost with the interest, with the actual loan, and with my with the sale of the car. It was really not worth it. I spent from 9 o'clock to 5 o'clock in the office working. I leave my home at 8 o'clock so that I am in my office at 9 o'clock, and the entire time I'm working, and what? I waste my resources, my energy, and everything, my time, my life, on paying a car. Did I actually think that that car was worth my time, my energy, and my life on? No, necessarily not. So that was one of the very important learnings I have had. Yes, a car is necessary for us to go from point A to point B, but you don't necessarily have to be in a flashy, fast, huge, beautiful German car when you go from point A to point B. So that's one learning. Now, one thing is that I have to tell you that I did make a mistake of buying a German car. It was a BMW. It was not top of the line, but it was expensive. It was an expensive one. It was not only expensive with the purchase, it was expensive to maintain the bloody car. It's not a joke. It was one of the mistakes that I've had. So I thought to myself, it's not brand new. I'm not taking a loan on it. I thought during the time it's suitable that I experienced the pleasure of driving a German car. Indeed, it was a pleasure driving a German car. But again, what was it really worth the money that I spent my life earning and spend it on that car? I could have taken that money and bought a certain asset that actually would have given me a cash flow. And looking back, it was not worth the money and the time and the energy that I spent on to be able to pay that car. Yes, I did not take a loan. I paid for it in cash. Yes, it was not brand new. It was a used one. Nevertheless, the amount of money that I spent on that car, the lost value, the maintenance, and the value of that car when I purchased it, it was certainly not sufficient. It was not worthy of the time that I had to spend to earn that money and pay for it. It certainly was not. It would have been more worthy if I had spent it on a holiday, really, or further investing that money onto a certain asset. And right now, the car that I bought was a second-hand Mazda 3. Of course, I made some maintenance on it, some repairs on it, and the normal wear and tear is there, of course. But it serves me well. It takes me from point A to point B, and I'm happy with that. And I've driven this car quite lengthy drives. I went to Ontario, to Toronto with it, came back. I drive to different provinces within Canada with it, and it's a safe one. It's not a flashy one. It's not a kind of car that that would turn turn heads when they pass by. But I bought it in cash, paid for it in cash, and I own it, and I don't have to worry about any loan on that car. And this is another one less worry for me. I don't have to worry about car payments on a monthly basis. When I lost my job back in 2020, I didn't have to worry about my payment on my car. It was paid for, so I didn't have stress. When I lost my job, I didn't have to worry about my rent because my house is paid for. So there was no stress on that front. During the time, the only stress I had was with my mother, because my mother was asking me so many things. She was so worried that I didn't have a job, and she was worried that we wouldn't have money to buy groceries. That was the only stress I had during the time. But aside from that, really, and that's one of the beauty of having financial freedom. Again, I am still on that journey, that financial freedom journey. If I lose my job tomorrow, there is no fear, because I don't necessarily have so many debts that I have to worry about. Even my credit cards are paid for on a monthly basis on full. Remember, every single time that you spend your money on material things, you have to remember it's not just the money that you're spending, it's your time, it's your effort, it's your resources, it's not just your money, because it took you time to earn that money. And you have to truly evaluate if a certain material or a certain stuff is worthy of the time that you spend to earn that money. And that's it. Thank you very much, everyone, for watching this video. I do have some other videos that hopefully you can gain value or learn from. And so I've had those mistakes, so that you don't, and I'm sharing it with you so that you don't have to experience the same mistakes and commit the same mistakes.